Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you for this very warm welcome. Dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, athletes, I'm sure there are some athletes around here. Sports fans, many sports fans. I'm one of them. Welcome to everyone here to COP26. A few months ago, I watched some of the Olympics on television. As I was watching the winners receive their medals, I realized that while they may be standing on the podium alone, an entire team stood with them in spirit. I'm talking about the team that contributed to their success throughout their entire career, helping to train, to condition, to encourage the people who played a part in their ultimate success. We must look at our collective efforts to address climate change in a similar way. One person, one level of government, or one sector is not going to take us to the finish line. We need all people across all sectors and all walks of life doing their part. After all, we are not fighting for a medal, but for a chance to have a long future on this planet. The Paris Agreement represents our team strategy, one with a clear goal: to limit increase in temperature by the end of the century, preferably by 1.5 degree. The sports sector can get us there. It's a sector that is important not just economically, but one that inspires every day and influences millions throughout the world. In October of 2017, I challenged this sector to work with UN climate change towards a common objective: to put the sport industry on track to achieve net zero emissions by 2050. I also invited them to become part of UN Climate Change's Sports for Climate Action framework, aimed at supporting and guiding sports actors in achieving global climate change goals. The sector accepted that challenge. 4 years later, more than 280 sports organizations have committed to the overarching objectives of aligning sports with the goals of the Paris Agreement. They range from the International Olympic Committee, FIFA, as we just saw, to Liverpool Football Club, Formula One, Athletics Kenya, the New York Yankees, Team Malaysia, and many, many others. And the sector eagerly took up the challenge, but also told us that they want to do more and to do it faster. So those were exactly the kind of words, the kind of commitments we wanted to hear. So today in Glasgow, I am happy to unveil and launch the net zero targets put forward in the UNFCCC Sports for Climate Action. The headline is that sports organizations are being challenged to reduce emissions 50% by 2030 at the latest, and to achieve net zero emissions by 2040. By the way, this is more than what governments are being asked to do. Governments are currently being asked to be net zero by 2050. But we want sports to be the winners. That's a full decade ahead of what many sectors are working towards. And it is true to the nature of its work, the sector wants to set the pace for other sectors to follow. As we have seen, many have already taken up the challenge. But we urge all sports organizations to follow. UN Climate Change will be there to support you each step of the way. We can help amplify efforts and actions that you undertake to achieve greater impact, whether that's policy, publicity, or technology. In short, we can help you spread the good news. And by signing up to Sports for Climate Action Targets, sports signatories join the race to zero. I know the climate champion has already talked about that in greater detail. Friends, I want to take this opportunity to thank the organizations who have already joined the Sports for Climate Action Framework and have contributed so much already. Your ideas and your enthusiasm show your determination and why you are successful in your line of work. But let's keep it going. I ask you to help us continue building this great team to address climate change. Talk to other organizations and encourage them to join. Talk about your efforts and why it is important to you. Talk about climate change and how it will impact the health of athletes, or probably it's already impacting the health of athletes, whether games are held or canceled, and the jobs associated with all aspects of sports. Tell them it's about protecting the game on the field and the challenge outside the stadium, the fight against climate change we are all involved in. Thank you for your efforts. Thank you for taking up this exciting challenge and for the work that we will be doing together to achieve our collective goals. And please also help us inspire all your fans throughout the world. That will make definitely a huge difference.